Today we're in Philadelphia, known for a lot of things. The Liberty Bell, Ben Franklin, Rocky, cheesesteak, and housing stock like this, Philadelphia row houses. Now, Lois, you're one of the homeowners of these beautiful houses.
Yes, welcome to Philly, Richard.
Nice to be here.
Nice to meet you.
This is your little piece of heaven?
Yes, definitely. So I bought this home about 4 years ago.
Yeah.
From Habitat for Humanity.
Great.
Did their home ownership program.
Super.
And the kids are loving having their own rooms.
Great.
Yes.
And what are you doing now these days?
So now I actually work for Habitat for Humanity.
Oh, great.
So I started off in their repair department, helping other families get repairs. Now I'm helping families get a home. I'm doing a home ownership program.
Good for you.
Yes.
But you wrote us that maybe we might be able to help you. You have a little issue inside the house.
Yes, please. Let me show you.
Good. Let's go.
All right, so welcome to our beautiful kitchen.
Love it.
So I really like to cook, especially bake. My two children love baked ribs. And so a few months ago, we started smelling gas. And so it really scared me.
Yeah.
So the gas company thinks that it's coming from the stove. So we've only been using the top.
Only been using the top?
Okay. Only been using the top. So no, we haven't baked in a few months, and we really miss baked ribs.
All right, so I could actually get down in there and try to find the leak, seal it up. But you know what? I noticed you don't have a vent to outside either. So, you know what? That stove doesn't owe you anything, I think. How about a little upgrade? Could that work?
That would be amazing.
All right, I'll be back. Careful.
Okay.
All right. Ooh. What do you think?
This is nice.
All right, I need you to meet three new friends. First is Kelly Ireland, a local plumber who's going to help us. I'm not licensed as a plumber here in Pennsylvania, but she is, so she's going to help us make the connections correctly.
Hi, Kelly. Nice to meet you.
Thank you for having me in your home.
This is your new gas range, 30-inch gas range, and this is a 30-inch microwave, but it also has the vent hood that goes to outside.
Oh, that's great.
Awesome pick on your oven.
Thank
but
you.
I'm really glad you went with the microwave with the vent hood, because when you cook with any gas appliance, you can have incomplete combustion, which releases a little bit of contaminants. It's safe, but it's always best to get it out of your house if possible.
Yeah. A lot of times you just have, like you have, it just recirculates, so it's really great. All right, you're not gonna be able to start baking and cooking unless we get going. So let's get rolling. Let's turn the gas off and get this old one out of here.
All right.
I'll let you guys get to it.
All right. Love seeing you protect the counters. Nicely done. All right, let's get that range out of the way and turn off the gas. All right, you're smaller than me. You can go in there.
All right, I'll squeeze in. A little bit more. Okay.
Gas cock off. Gas is off, the union connection is broken, and you can just unplug that electrical plug when you come out. Good.
All right.
Awesome. We good?
Yep.
Look at you go.
Yep.
Guns.
Got my big muscles
Got
on.
Got your guns. All right, a little discovery here. The gas line comes up in the middle of this opening, and it comes up to about 6 inches. And that was fine for the old stove, because on the back of that stove, there was plenty of room to run the flex, but not the case on the new stove. The new one has this box in the back, which means there's barely enough room, so we're gonna have to modify the pipe a little bit to have space. Never easy.
To get the clearance for the flex pipe and the new stove, we'll first remove this threaded adapter. We'll use a multi-tool to cut back the sheetrock to give us room to insert this elbow. This new angle will allow for the connection to be made behind the new stove. Now we can turn our attention to removing the old microwave.
You got that in?
Yep. Good.
Our new venting microwave is secured to the wall with these brackets. We'll modify the cabinet to accept the vent flange.
Great.
Okay.
And I want you to hold it.
Got it. Look at that.
Now, any of these microwave exhaust combinations have a choice to exhaust straight out the back or at the top as we've done right here. And it comes off the center of the unit. But look what also is at the center of the unit. That's a stud, a 2x4 wall stud. If we ever drilled a hole there, we take all the structure outside of the wall, so we can't. So what we want to do is to offset the exhaust right like this. So that means that we're going to come over here and X marks the spot.
It starts with a pilot hole. Then we'll switch to our hole saw.
Nicely done.
And I'll finish the through cut from the outside by matching our hole saw onto our pilot hole. Now we can mark and cut our vent pipe to length.
On the money.
Perfect.
Attach it to the flange and secure it in place.
All right, Kelly, close enough?
Yep, good.
Okay, make your connection. One important installation step is this anti-tip bracket. It's designed to key onto the back leg to avoid the reins from ever tipping over, okay? All right, Kelly, just be sure that we don't kink that flexible line and just help me guide onto that anti-tip leg.
Tip it to you, right there.
Look at that. And that goes right in beautiful, okay? Okay, I think we're there, right? And that's, we're keyed onto this. All right, so let's just level. Just try bringing that front leg up, please. Okay, nice. Oh, the posse is here. Hi, guys.
Hi.
Hi. Who are you?
Cameron.
Hi, Cameron. Richard.
Jade.
Hi, Jade. You excited?
Yep.
What's the first thing you want Mom to cook?
Ribs.
I'm staying for dinner.
I'm staying too. Well, here it is.
It looks amazing.
It's great.
Yeah.
Thank you.
It's got an air fryer. It doesn't leak. You don't smell any gas. That's a good thing.
Yes.
And what I love is this right here. It's vented to outside.
Okay.
So that's going to make sure all the contaminants go outside.
And you can use it for your stove and your oven. Yeah. Okay. And it'll take all the smoke and everything out.
All right.
Oh, great.
We hope you guys cook for your kids and your kids' kids and enjoy it forever. See
Thank
you guys.
Thank you.
Right. Bye, you. Honors?
Yes, we want to try it on.
I'm going to cook some eggs.
Thanks for watching. This Old House has got a video for just about every home improvement project. So be sure to check out the others. And if you like what you see, click on the subscribe button. Make sure that you get our newest videos right in your feed.